Hello, it's Thursday, April 14th, and I'm Lee Stone with the Daily Outlook from UFX Markets. The dollar was mixed against the other major currencies as mixed data was released. Retail sales rose for the ninth straight month, coming out at 0.8% versus 0.7% that was forecast. And U.S. business inventories came out less than expected in February, 0.5% versus 0.8% forecast. Also, President Barack Obama said that he has outlined a plan to cut the budget deficit by $4 trillion in 12 years. This led investors to prefer higher-yielding assets with regards to the plan mentioned. The Nasdaq and Dow Jones increased by 0.61% and 0.06% respectively. Crude oil weakened by 0.3%, closing at $106.99 a barrel. Gold rose by 0.4%, closing at $1,457 an ounce. Today, the PPI is expected to be 1% versus 1.6% prior. And unemployment claims are also expected to decline from 382,000 to 380,000. The euro weakened against the dollar after industrial output in the eurozone expanded less than expected in February, coming out at 0.4% versus 0.8% that was forecast. Also, there is concern that Greece's sovereign debt crisis may be getting worse. This caused investors to prefer other currencies. The euro-US dollar's momentum is still bullish, and as long as the rate is above 143.70, the pair will probably continue to rise towards 145 or possibly even more. Overall, euro-USD traded with a low of 144.13 and with a high of 145.20. Today, the ECB monthly bulletin will be released. The pound fluctuated versus the dollar and closed almost unchanged after the claimant count change was released and appears to have unexpectedly risen in March. The figures came out at 0.7 versus minus 3.6 that had been forecast. In addition, the unemployment rate came out better than expected at 7.8% versus 8% forecast, causing the pound to be unstable during the session. The next support level of the GBP/USD on the 4-hour chart is located at 162.25, and if the pair breaks below this level, the pound will continue to be negative. Overall, GBP/USD traded with a low of 162.37 and with a high of 163.09. No economic data is expected today. The yen fluctuated against the dollar in the end closed almost unchanged as global stocks advanced and a report showed that U.S. retail sales rose for a ninth straight month, which encouraged investors to seek higher-yielding assets. The USDJPY's momentum has been bearish over the past few days, and the next support level on the 4-hour chart is at 83.50. If the pair breaks the support level, it will probably decline below the 83 level. Overall, USDJPY traded with a low of 83.57 and with a high of 84.26. No economic data is expected today. The Canadian dollar fell against the other major currencies as the Bank of Canada said economic growth will slow following a strong burst at the start of the year, after they decided to keep their interest rate target at 1%. As long as the pair is trading below 0.97 levels, a short position is still preferred and the momentum resides with the Canadian dollar. The next support line on the 1-hour chart is located at 0.9585. And overall, USD CAD traded with a low of 0.9585 and with a high of 0.9655. Today, manufacturing sales are expected to be at 0.6% versus 4.5% prior. Well, that's all the news we have for today. Be sure to visit us at ufxmarkets.com for simple, safe, and secure trading.